Now come to subordinating conjunctions. Their subordinating conjunctions are actually, they join a clause to another on which it depends for its full meaning. Okay, a subordinating conjunction joins a clause to another one which it depends for its full meaning. एक क्लॉज हमारा दूसरे क्लॉज से जॉइन करता है जिससे कि वो पूरा सेकेंड वाला जो क्लॉज होता है दैट कम्प्लीटली बिकम्स डिपेंडेंट अपॉन द फर्स्ट क्लॉज. सी हाउ. सो देयर आर थ्री काइंड ऑफ कंजंक्शन नोन एज सब. थर्ड काइंड ऑफ कंजंक्शन इज सबऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन. टेक अ लुक एट दीज सेंटेंसेस. आई गॉट अ प्लेट बिकॉज आई डिड नॉट हियर द अलार्म. सो बिकॉज. He is sad since he has lost the race. Meera jumped with joy when Seema got the prize. So in the above examples, there are two parts of speech or two clauses in each sentence. Kaun kaun se? Just see, I got a plate because I did not hear the alarm. Next, he is sad since he has lost the race. Meera jumped with joy when Seema got the price. मतलब यहाँ पे हमारे पास टू पार्ट्स ऑफ या तो क्लॉजेस हो रहे हैं या तो टू पार्ट्स ऑफ सेंटेंसेस हो रहे हैं. ठीक है. जो सबॉर्डिनेटिंग कंजंक्शन प्लेस करने के बाद डिवाइड हो जाते हैं. ओके. सो इन ऑल दीज एग्जाम्पल्स द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फर्स्ट इन ऑर्डर टू बी मीनिंगफुल. सच क्लॉजेस आर नोन एज सबॉर्डिनेट clause. The conjunctions that join such a clause to the main clause are known as subordinating conjunctions. ठीक है. जो according to this that the second part of the sentence which is dependent upon the first part, तो ये वाला जो हमारा part होता है this is known as subordinate clause. Okay, which is the dependent on the first one. Now, look at the underlined words in the sentence given below. So, what are the words underlined over here? The word underlined over here is that, because it is joining two parts of sentences over here. So, this that stands for conjunction. And when it connects the sentence, a part of sentence depends on the other or is subordinate to other for meaning. So over here, that Mr. Jones will not return by itself does not make any sense. So that is why it is fortunate is helping it out to make it a complete sense. So hence such words that connect two parts of sentences such that one part depends on the other for meaning are known as subordinating conjunctions. Now, punctuation with subordinating conjunctions. An independent clause is a group of words with a subject and a verb. Independent clause की जब हम बात करते हैं तो independent clause क्या होता है? जब उस group of words में हमारे पास एक subject होता है और एक verb होता है. And they can stand alone as a sentence. They can stand as alone as a sentence. So for example, Rita goes to the classroom. So Rita and goes, we have a subject and a verb. So adding a subordinating conjunction will automatically make the clause dependent. अगर हम एकदम से उसमें subordinating conjunction लगा देते हैं तो हमारा जो sentence रहता है वो automatically dependent clause बन जाता है. For example, when Rita goes to classroom. So when लगाने के बाद क्या हो गया? Now that Rita goes to classroom dependent हो गया. कैसे? क्योंकि इसके आगे इसके पीछे कुछ मेरे पास नहीं है. When Rita goes to classroom तो क्या? Then we have got nothing. So this is not making any complete sense. After Rhea goes to the classroom. No, because Rhea goes to the classroom. We have nothing, no idea about it ki when, after and because shows what. So we need to have some help independent clause another clause also. So if the dependent clause is placed at the beginning of the sentence, the dependent clause must be separated from the independent clause by a comma. For example, after Riya goes to classroom, she goes to the library. मतलब यहाँ पे हमारे एक dependent clause, यहाँ पे उसको एक reason मिल गया. Now if the dependent clause is placed at the end, यहाँ पे हमारा dependent clause पहले starting of the sentence में था, अब हमारा dependent clause हम बात करेंगे when it is placed at the end of the sentence. So what you have over here, Rita goes to the library after she goes to the classroom. Okay, so this is how it works. If the dependent clause is inserted into the middle, or jab hamara dependent clause sentence ke beech mein aata hai, so in that case the clause acts as a parenthetical element and should have commas on both the sides. So on Monday, comma, after she goes to the classroom, comma, Rita goes to the library. This is how it works. So what are there are some examples given over here of subordinating clause, so just go through them. Now let us take the exercise. Underline the subordinating conjunctions in the sentence given below. So I cannot understand why you don't do your work. We have to underline the subordinating clause. Over here we have the subordinating clause as why. Next, this house is where your grandfather lived. So where? Since you have told me the truth, I will forgive you since. Okay, so in the same way, try solving the next sentences. Okay, so don't forget to read this box. Now coming to the fourth exercise, choose the appropriate subordinating conjunction from the box given below and complete the sentence. So in the box you have been given with the subordinating clause as a answer. So let's take first two only. Rest you can solve it by your own. Sheila can attend the meeting - she doesn't say anything. So the answer can be Sheila can attend the meeting as long as she doesn't say anything. Okay. Next, the teacher will not leave - the students have completed their work. The teacher will not leave until the students have completed their work. So this is how you have to solve this exercise. Try to complete this exercise. Okay, now come to the fifth exercise. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate conjunctions. Now it can be either coordinating conjunction, correlative conjunction, or a subordinating conjunction. So let us take first two. My dad - I are going finish fishing this afternoon. So over here you'll have his answer as and. So my dad and I are going fishing this afternoon. Now B, he behaves - he rules the world. He behaves as though he rules the world, or as if. Okay, now try solving this exercise by your own. Now come to the sixth exercise. Rewrite the following paragraph using either coordinating or subordinating conjunctions. Okay, there is no use of using correlative, just coordinating and subordinating conjunction. And remember to place on the commas as well. So try doing it by your own. Okay, and that's it. Thank you.